Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lovers. This is Clémence. I talk about fragrance. Welcome back. Today we talk about cheap and good. Just like me. No. Maybe not. What? Why am I saying those kind of things? Anyway, let's start. Today's video, like I said, we are talking about cheap and good, well, affordable fragrance. We're talking about men's today, we'll talk about ladies on another time. You don't always need to spend a lot of money to smell good. I think in a collection it's really important to have some things that are more easygoing, easy to apply for an everyday basis. You don't want to wear all the time your Creed fragrance, your Chanel on an everyday basis that you spend so much money on it. You need good cheapies, and sometimes they can surprisingly smell as good as a very expensive fragrance. However, you need to be aware of the quality of ingredients. So let me show you that. My first one is called Mont Blanc, and I say blanc without saying the C, please. Mont Blanc Explorer. This actually will be the most expensive one of the cheap fragrance, but it's still ultra affordable. So I want to give a little thank you first to Essential. This is a website, and let's go also a nice Instagram where you can buy a lot of different from different brands and different fragrance. And they've been sending that fragrance for me to tell what I think about it. Thank you. That's really nice. Especially without asking anything in exchange. That's very nice. Wanted to say it. I didn't know Mont Blanc Explorer before because one of my first internship was actually for Mont Blanc. Well, actually for a group, a fragrance group that is called Interparfums. I've got a lot of different brands and there's Mont Blanc inside. So I used to sell it, train people on Mont Blanc. I really like their fragrance. Back in the day, we didn't have an Explorer because it's been a really long time, trust me, since my first internship. So I love this fragrance. It's mostly known because people compare it to Aventus, but I'm gonna explain to you how I think they pretty different to me. It basically smells like a mass appealing fragrance to me. I was not too sure I was gonna like it, and I was like, I would put this in the same category of Sauvage from Dior. I would put it, yeah, okay, Aventus, those colognes that are so easy to wear and so mass appealing, because I would say they compliment getter, because what, you've got this mystery ingredient that gets always compliments is ambroxan. This molecule is so much projecting this intense freshness and somewhat spiciness. It gives a lot of projection and therefore a lot of compliment. Slightly green, and there's an opening that is very fruity. What fruit? I don't know, because it smells quite synthetic to my nose. So when it smells synthetic, it means in my sense that you can't really smell one ingredient specifically. It's not really there. It's more like a blend of fruitiness at the beginning, and you can smell a slight touch of leather, but again, it's more like a blend, really. You can't really smell it technically. So it's a woody scent, earthy, woody, very fresh at the start. So I would say it's ideal for an everyday men cologne, and I really enjoy it. I think it smells smart and it smells nice for office, French and minty to my nose, slightly mint. It's a very well blended fragrance, like I said, because you can really smell the pyramid of notes. It goes to fruity, to something more green, to something more woodier, and I really enjoy that. I think it's really nicely done. And I was saying to you that I work for the group that is doing this fragrance, and I know they put research into their fragrance, so I can tell you that they are nicely done. Smells really masculine, really mass appealing. It makes me think of Jeremy fragrance when I smell it. But I don't know, this kind of vibe, you know, he's trendy, he's active, he's got this suit all the time. So, I think it's a really good fragrance to have in your collection, because it's something you can wear on an everyday basis, and the performance is amazing. I had it on my skin and I was surprised how it lasts during the day, and also I find it much more interesting on the skin. It's got much more deepness and richness. and I really enjoy it. It smells qualitative to me. Find it for a very affordable and cheap price all over the internet. It smells ultra clean, nearly like you just shaved, you know. And the bottle is beautiful. Honestly, the details. But that's what Montblanc does the best. Simple but efficient.
Oh, and by the way, if you are wondering, I do find Aventus a bit more juicier, somewhat more defined, with more natural ingredients, a bit more louder, and slightly more powdery. So for me, that's quite a difference. But double the price. Triple, maybe. Ooh.
In February is actually two fragrances, so I've done a video on them, so if you want to have a look, here it is. Encre noire à l'extrême and encre noire sport from Lalique. So if you ask me, I like the encre noire, have a go for the video to see what I really think. But with trying with the time, I like encre noire, but it does have that very inky, of course it's called ink in French, encre mean ink. Inky smell that is a bit too much for me, that I can't assume personally on my skin. So I really love the sport, I really fell in love from the sport. First of all, the color of the juice is like a dark blue, like turquoise. I find it so fascinating to watch. Cashmere vetiver scent, so if you like vetiver, you know, this intense earthiness, you're gonna love that. It's aromatic and you really can smell something very soothing with the lavender, and that's actually my favorite, the sport one. The performance compared to the other one is a bit more lighter, it doesn't stay as long, but it's much more softer, slightly more powdery. With this greenness that is still here, but it's a bit more marine scent, using tone that the sport got. I really enjoy the extreme as well. If you like intense, you want more woods, you want more depth to your fragrance, you're gonna really enjoy it. It's actually very strong, the extreme. It's like a very oriental undertone, which is made by benzoin, so it's nearly like waxy smell at the end. Resinous, so like pine tree, that's because of the cypress. Really enjoy that. Slightly incensey tone, so if you want again more darkness, the price are incredibly stunning. Like, these are 100 milliliters. I got them for £50, not each, the two. So £25 each, and that was on Notino. The bottle of stunnings, good price, amazing fragrance. Stash from SGP, Sarah Jessica Parker. So I don't know if this is discontinued, so if you want it, I would say jump on it. I bought it initially because I'm a big fan of Santal blush from Tom Ford, and somebody told me that it smells like this because there's this very creamy sandalwood in there. Definitely is with this one. It smells very woody, and there's this sage that gives something very mysterious to this fragrance. However, in this one, you can really smell more the fruit. The grapefruit is really present to me. Nearly something quite acidic to it, but you can smell a very smooth sandalwood, nearly like a pencil shaving sandalwood, with a very boozy accord and very strong. More masculine to me than feminine. Very woody. Nearly there's something like acidic lemony in there that is really interesting. And it smells like very sensual and sexy, I think. And if you like the Tom Ford a bit approach, you know, when it's everything is a bit more mysterious, charming, you know, and very intense, you're gonna love Stash. This is such a gem. The price is such a gem too. I think I bought my bottle around £18 or something like that. Like, very, very cheap for 100 milliliters. Really look like a very luxurious bottle. It's a bit more evening-ish. You can wear that easily during the day on winter. Number four is, of course, my favorite. It's in my introduction. How can I not talk about it? Guerlain Vetiver. So you know how much I love this fragrance. This is a 200 milliliters bottle that I got in TK Maxx for not more than £15 or something like that. Like, it was really cheap, so I jumped on it because I love Guerlain Vetiver. Compared to the other Encre Noire Vetiver and what is in the Montblanc Explorant, this is much more vintage. You need to like a proper gentleman scent. So it's classy, it's much more classic than the other one as well. You can wear that on an everyday basis, like you go to a park. The one are more trendy to me. This is, for me, ultimate classic. So I won't put all the ingredients in there. You just have to think that it's something that is a bit fruitier, there's a bit of spice, cedar, sandalwood, woody notes, but it's not heavy at all. It's very refreshing, made in a very light way. However, with this profusion of hundreds of ingredients, it does stay really long on the skin. Really nice performance, and really an timeless classic to me, classy for cheap, because you can find that all over the internet for a very amazing price. So it's not just TK Maxx or TJ Maxx that you have in America. You can really find it easily for a very cheap price, and really it does worth it because it's an ultimate classic and everyone needs an ultimate classic. My last one is a Zara fragrance and it's called Rich Home and Addictive. I absolutely love this fragrance. That's my scent of the day today because of the honeyed coconut smell. So if you like a bit more exotism, it's part of the Tobacco collection. There's tobacco in there, but personally I can't really smell the tobacco in there. I really smell something more exotic. Of course there's woods, you know, however you can't really smell them because it smells synthetic, you know, so you can't really tell, oh okay, this is sandalwood. Ooh, sandalwood tobacco. Yes, no. It's really a blend. It's quite smooth and round, very round actually. It smells more sweeter. That's the sweetest of it all because of that honey touch and this coconut. Sweet, exotic, really warm scent. So enveloping, it feels cocooning, like you're secure, something like that. I really love to wear it. I can't remember how much was it, but very ridiculous price, honestly. If you don't know which Zara, because usually, and Zara doesn't have tester at the moment, with Zara to take, oh my god, go for this one. It's really good for the price. Of course, don't expect something that smells ultra not synthetic. It's synthetic, so it's a blend of ingredients, but beautiful. If you want a bit of that sweetness on you without smell feminine, you are gonna love this. And it's not a sticky honey, which is nice. It's just, you know, a pinch of honey. Beautiful. So anyway, so that was my favorite cheapy colognes for men, fragrance for men. I feel a bit like a blaspheme to say cologne for men, but referencement of the video. Thanks YouTube. A cologne is not a fragrance technically, that's why I'm always like feeling I'm blaspheming on fragrance when I say cologne for men. But this is something that is now, it's been adapted especially for the US dictionary. They added the word cologne as a perfume for men. But it's still a perfume, guys. You're wearing perfume. Just to let you know. Normally a cologne is not that. A cologne is a concentration of a fragrance and it means something to refresh you after the shower. So it's technically more, we need to call them more fragrance if you want to be totally like on the paper. But I said today, let's adapt to the modern dictionary, Clémence. Don't do snobbish frag head and call it a cologne for once. Anyway, like if you find this video interesting, subscribe to my channel, leave me a little like, it helps also to reference the video. It's always such a pleasure to talk to you about fragrance and I hope you enjoyed it. You have also my uTip account on the description box if you want to give me a little tip. For those who didn't take them ticket for Scent Explore, it's Saturday! It's Saturday already, I'm so stressed, oh my god, I'm so stressed, I can't wait. You've got the link down below if you want to book your ticket, it's not too late. And it's Saturday all day, virtually, I cannot wait. So, I wish you a good evening and I will see you soon. Bye now!